Listen up, young people. There's something going on right now, as I speak, as you sit, as you text, that I bet you have no idea is happening. There's a tsunami coming for America. The first United States Secretary on Aging, Fernando Torres Gil, calls it the silver tsunami. Others call it the shockwave, the pig and the python. I can keep going. You may have even heard President Obama mention it several times as a warning in his budget speeches. All these references are referring to the baby boomers. Here's the situation. Back in the day, after World War II was over, 16 million soldiers came back from the war. They came back to anxiously awaiting wives. Boom. What happened next is history, literally. So now we have the biggest boom of babies in US history, growing older and older. The boomers are considered those born from 1946 to 1964. Easy to remember, 46, 64. This year, 2011, the first wave of baby boomers are starting to turn 65. Gerontologists, professionals focused on older people, have been warning politicians and the rest of us for years. But who's gonna listen to a boring gerontologist? No one. That's where our voice comes in. That's part of why we created a movement. When we get older, we start to need certain types of care, certain types of medicine. We all know it, but try to convince ourselves otherwise. We try to convince ourselves that if we're okay today, we'll be okay tomorrow, and nothing's gonna change. I learned in a gerontology class taught by Dr. Butcher at UCLA that over time, everything changes. Everything declines. Every organ, your heart, your lungs, your liver, your skin. But there's only one thing that stays consistent throughout your life. That's your personality and your sense of what's important. So training ourselves to pay attention to seniors is something we need to start early on in our lives so that it can remain with us through high school, through college, through life. Most people don't know this, but after heavy research, it's been declared this year that old people are not a different species. They're younger people from the past. It's kind of like a reverse Back to the Future. But this time, we need Rose where we're going. You're welcome, Andrew. He had me include that. I'm talking to Andrew Gerges, by the way, my brother. Give it up. Seniors. From now on, every time you talk to an older person, look into their eyes and see the youth, see the you, the younger person, see yourself in them. It's fun to think about that famous line, today is the oldest you have ever been and the youngest you will ever be again. Aging matters. It's not some specific disease that affects some people. We all have a family history of aging. Aging starts at a very specific age for our specific species, age zero. Ooh. You're here accepting awards for your accomplishments. That means that you probably like to succeed, and you want to succeed. You want to continue to succeed in health, in life, everywhere. The thing is, though, that you can't succeed if you don't look into the future and make a concrete plan. You all know this. That's why you're here. There's nothing more guaranteed, though, about our future than the fact that we will all age. So we aren't successful until we're thinking about that part of our lives, planning for it, making sure we're going to be okay. When you think of aging or gerontology, don't just think of doctors or medicine. That's not the right way to go. Gerontology is anything dealing with the elderly, elder law, elder architecture, tech training for seniors, innovations, inventions that'll make senior living easy. As Dr. Butcher puts it, it's almost impossible to find a single discipline where you cannot, regardless of your training, apply to gerontology. There's something for everyone. Not many people my age will tell you this, but just like how years ago, most of us didn't know how big technology would be, in 10, definitely 15 years, aging will be big, big. Big in a way that'll be very noticeable. We know Florida to be the retirement state with the largest senior population in US in the U.S. By the time we're adults, the whole country's going to look like Florida. So the message here is to invest early in planning for your career, whatever it is, to somehow include older people. Those are going to be the majority of your customers, your clients, your patients. My one piece of advice: when people tell you that life is short, laugh at them. Life is long. Life's long. It's only getting longer. It is only getting longer. With ever-increasing longevity, life is only getting longer. So it's vital to plan for the future. When you think about aging, the next thing that should come up in your mind is Alzheimer's disease. Forget everything you know about Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's isn't just an old person's disease, and it doesn't just stop at memory loss. People in their 30s and 40s are being diagnosed now. Without question, Alzheimer's is the illness of the 21st century. Anyone can get it. It's a flip of a coin. It's the one disease that doesn't require a family history. Someone did the math and found out that Alzheimer's is being diagnosed every 69 seconds, and that 5 million people have it. That's more than a million people. Alzheimer's disease has got to be the scariest of them all. Imagine the first time sons and daughters have heard their parents ask, "What's your name?" to their own son or daughter. Alzheimer's disease has got to be the scariest ever. Imagine you're that person with Alzheimer's disease, where early on you know that one day you're not going to exist mentally, that someone's throwing your memories of who you are, who you love, what you like to do in the recycle bin and clicking empty trash. There's no way going back. This past weekend, when I asked my younger cousin, Peyton, what he knew about Alzheimer's disease, he told me, "It's when old people forget their memory." Sorry, Peyton, that's not good enough. I know you're 12, but still not good enough. Memory loss is only a small part of the disease. Alzheimer's slowly kills all neurons in your brain that control everything. It starts with the neurons that control memory, yes, but then moves on to the neurons that kill your ability to speak, and then your ability to move, and the ones that tell your body to breathe and your heart to beat. The great thing about us, though, when we're young, is that we could do the hard work that adults can't do, that they don't have time for. What? Does it make sense to make them do the research and the awareness? It's not logical. It's not going to happen. Okay, raise your hand if you've been texting or status checking since this talk. Dr. Fox is going to be coming by to collect your phones. Just joke. Let me tell you why a lot of you just got nervous. So I have a younger brother and sister, Andrew, Miriam, and Esperanza. Give it up. And tons of younger cousins. Man, you guys are nuts with that technology. I don't count myself out. I'm hooked too. But people my age, around 26 or so, we max out our Facebook comments about 10, 15 max. You guys, man, I've seen 98 comments on a status before. I dig you guys, but seriously, you need to calm down. I'm not talking about anyone here, but people we know very well. They can't wait until the next red light to text. When they do get to a red light, it's a text and online party time. Man, it's the first time in the history of driving that drivers have prayed for a red light. How can we have patience for our elders who are moving at a slower speed when we're in hyperspeed? Things have changed. When I call my little brother, he doesn't pick up the phone. I call him, and what comes back? A text that says, "Sup." If you've been listening so far, you now see better how aging and Alzheimer's disease are not like any other issue or disease. These issues are a boulder that we all have to hold up and soon push out of the way. Because with the boomers getting older and older, the boulder's getting heavier and heavier on healthcare, on politics, on taxpayers, all taxpayers, on families, on us. So we at UGATA, the organization that we started, we put words into actions at theyouthmovement.org. We started the movement. Now, more of us just have to keep it moving. At the end of the day, I feel good because progress is being made, and I'm here as a testament to that. We figured out a way to help our country, and that is to give you all a heads up of what's going on. If you decide you want to start a group for these issues at your school, for those of you still at Esperanza, or at your new college, for those of you graduating, let us know. If you want to help us find groups all across the U.S. that already exist to invite them to join, let us know. If you just want to join, let us know. It's that easy. Any age is welcome. Remember, it's the way you think, not your age, that makes you youthful. When it comes to aging, we're all the same. In the words of Drake, everybody dies, but not everybody lives. Tonight, I leave you with the oath that our members take upon initiation. They hold their right hand over a book that our advisor, Dr. Gary Small, wrote called the Memory Bible. And they repeat after me. Feel free to join along if you want, if you're ready. Here's the oath, just so you know what's going on. I, state your name, do take upon me. Did I hear some people joining? All right. Do take upon me my generational responsibility to see people who are older. Faster, guys. As the young people they are inside, I promise to smile and notice those people who I subconsciously brush off. Copy paste. I accept my youth's promise to be involved in this nation's movement. Until the day where the movement has caused change. Older people have the right of way. And lastly, I will never honk at an older person on the road, even if I'm late to class. That's the oath. That's the speech. Congratulations, kids. May God bless you, and may God bless the United States of America. Thank you.